What's up, guys? Jay, Morning After Kill, and I'm back here on Borderlands 3. Now, before we start, I want to get this out of the way. I love Borderlands 3, hands down. There's not much about this game that I would change. Even the things that Gearbox has changed so far, I'm alright with. You know, legendaries dropping too much? Cool. Tone down the loot drops a little bit. I'm fine with that. Some characters or gear are doing way too much damage way too easily. Cool. I agree. Balance them out. Fix them. Whatever you gotta do to make the game more fun with more replayability, that's awesome. May suck at first, but in the long run, we'll be fine. But this Gearbox is broken, and it needs to be fixed. The Anointed Militants need a cooldown on how often they can do their fire immunity phase. It's crazy. By the time their fire immunity phase is over, and you go back in for a damage phase, yeah, he's doing it again. It's almost like the programmable AI in the game is programmed ass backwards. Like, his immunity stage should last as long as his damage phase currently lasts. Now, I have no issue with any of the other anointeds in the game. You know, I don't have no problem with their damage being crazy. I have no issue with their damage reduction being through the roof, but goddamn, please give the Anointed Militants a cooldown on their fire immunity damage phase. Because you can see here in this footage that this is the same run, the same loaded instance, the same modifiers. I had no issue fighting this Anointed Militant because he wasn't constantly spamming his fire immunity. But for some reason, that's not always the case. And if you come across this, you know how annoying it is of fighting an Anointed Militant who is constantly spamming his fire immunity, and you're sitting there fighting him for literally like 5 to 10 minutes, just trying to whittle down a little bit of damage by a little bit of damage, and then GTFOing before he sets you on fire with his massive dot damage. Like I said, I got no problem with the massive dot damage. But goddamn, can I get a window of opportunity longer than 2.5-3 seconds to put some damage down on this motherfucker? Goddamn. But I digress. This game is fun. However, this enemy, his mechanics, it is not. And it's broken. So I want you guys to tell me what you think in the comment section down below. Have you run across this? Have you had this issue at all in game? Because I know from talking to you guys on Twitter and Twitch that I am not the only one that this happens to. And to be honest, it really shouldn't happen to anybody. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. My name's Jay, More Than After Kill. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna see y'all motherfuckers later.
Helping hands. Always remember that. Yeah.
Ugh.